everyone, and welcome back to Licklibrary. My name is Leigh Fuge, and in this video today, we're going to be checking out the guitar style and habits of Iron Maiden guitar player Janick Gers. In this video, we're going to be checking out some of his main habits. I have prepared a Janick Gers style guitar solo for you, and we're going to extract some elements of what he's doing in that solo so you can take those away and put into your own playing. All the sections of this video are timestamped down below in the description, so you can go check those out if you want to fast forward ahead to your favorite section. If you want to check out the guitar style and habits of the other Iron Maiden guitar players, Adrian Smith and Dave Murray, there's a link in the top corner of this video, and there's also some links to those videos down below in the description. So let's get straight in and see what Janick Gers is doing. Here is the guitar solo that we're going to be extracting some habits from. So the first thing we're going to be doing is looking at Janick's use of tremolo picking and some accidental pinched harmonics. Now, throughout this video, I'm going to preface everything I say with the fact that Janick is quite an erratic player. So if you've already checked out the Dave Murray and Adrian Smith style videos, you'll know those guys are a little bit more thought out and meticulous. Janick is a bit more off the wall, so a lot of the things we're going to talk about in this video are a little bit more conceptual, because really a lot of what Janick does is going for a vibe. He is a bit more aggressive, a bit more, you know, off the wall, like I said. His playing sometimes doesn't make a lot of sense, but that's part of what he brings to the band. He is a little bit more of a loose cannon when it comes to note choice, so you don't have to worry too much if you're going for this Janick vibe of being super precise, super accurate, or super tight. You can be quite loose because, like I said, it's all about the vibe. So the first thing I'm going to do is check out a tremolo picking idea. Now, tremolo picking is when we pick a note consistently very, very fast. What Janick will do a lot in guitar solos, it'll play a note, possibly a string bend like I've done in the guitar solo that you've just checked out, and it'll sound like this. So I'm just picking that note to a steady rhythm. I can speed up if I want, and I can also alter my speed mid-bend to suit whatever I want to do. What Janick does a lot, and you hear that in the guitar solo, is almost adding some accidental pinched harmonics as we're doing this. So what I'm basically doing is, as I'm tremolo picking, I'm sort of moving my hand around and allowing the side of my thumb to brush the string in different places to add a few pinch harmonics to what I'm doing. Doesn't have to be an exact science, it's more of just a vibe, like I've said all along. So really we're just playing that one note, in this case the 7th fret of the G, and I'm bending it, and then I'm just picking the string. But as I'm doing that, I'm allowing my thumb to just hit some of those different harmonic points. You can sit at one harmonic point if you want, or you can move, just to get some different flavors in there. It's just a really simple technique that you can do, but it is very much something you'll hear Janick do a lot in different Maiden solos. It's quite a fun thing to do, and it does add a nice character to the sound. The second thing is basically another type of harmonic, and this kind of combines a trill with a harmonic. You would have seen me do this in the guitar solo, and really this technique is more about flair. This is basically something you would do to essentially be showy on stage, because if you've seen any live videos of Janick playing, he's very much about the performance aspect and really giving the crowd something to be entertained by. So what I did in the guitar solo was I did a trill here between the 5 and 7 of the G. which on its own is quite a simple thing to do. We're basically just doing a consistent hammer on pull off. But the showy thing is what I did with this hand. Above the pickups, I lightly rested my hand and I just moved it like this towards the neck and up. And as I'm doing this with a very, very light touch, what I'm actually doing is I'm activating harmonics while the trill keeps the string going. That again, purely is something you would do for fun. It doesn't really add any melodic value to a guitar solo, but it does look really cool when you do it on stage. It does have quite a cool sound, but like I said, it's not something you're going to use in every single guitar solo you play, but it is something that you will see Janick doing. It is a part of his style. You can do that all over the guitar, but I find that the 5th and 7th frets tend to work pretty well, because if you're playing Maiden stuff, you're typically going to be in E minor or A minor as pretty much as a rule. Those are the two keys they tend to write most of the material in. So that's the sort of region you'll expect to see it in an Iron Maiden song. But just to recap, it's basically a trill with the fret hand lightly brushing some harmonics along the string. You don't want to push down too hard because this will happen and you get absolutely nothing. And if you don't push down hard enough, you just get a trill. So it's finding the right balance to activate those harmonics. Make sure you put a bit of gain on, because a little bit of gain does help that come out, and make sure your guitar is set to the bridge pickup as well. So the third habit we're going to look at is Janick's use of fast note flurries. Now, if you check out some of the live footage of him, like I said, he can be a bit erratic, and some of these fast passages can be a little bit improvisational, let's say. But what I've done in this solo is I've written some that are a bit more solid and set in stone, so you can actually learn some of these concepts. So the lick I'm going to show you is this one. Now, while this is pretty fast, it's actually a lot easier to play than it sounds. What I'm actually doing is a hammer on and pull off from the 15 to the 12 of the E string. And then I'm playing the 15 on the B. Then I'm doing the same thing, but instead of the 15 of the E, I'm playing the 17. Similar to the Adrian Smith idea, there is a repeated theme here. We're basically just doing a hammer on pull off and then a fretted note. With the Janick Gers style in mind, you can play it a little bit sloppy like I intentionally did there. I let a little bit of string noise through because that's kind of what Janick does. You don't have to have it super clean. We're not playing any precise shred guitar here. We're playing Janick style, which is very much rock and roll and very loose. So that is the idea in a nutshell. But what Janick would do live is he would change some of those notes and he would add different notes and kind of change that shape around. You can start with this in one position like that to get a feel for this idea. Then you can kind of go down the road of making it a little bit more chaotic and a bit more erratic like Janick would. Start off slow with that because it is quite a fast lick, so just get the feel for it. Then go for the speed. And again, don't worry too much if it's a little bit messy and a little bit kind of sloppy. That's fine. That fits the Janick Gers guitar style perfectly. Janick also uses a lot of double stops in his solo. So this is the final habit we're going to check out, is double stops. Now, a double stop is when we play two notes together. So in the solo, I played this a few times. So what I'm doing there is I'm playing a double stop on the 14 of the G and B and on the 12. So the first thing I'm doing is I'm playing the 14 double stop, bending it and releasing it and pulling it off to the 12. Then I'm playing it again on the 14, picking it, and the 12 picking it. And then I'm playing the 14 and 12 on the D. This is kind of bluesy sounding. It works really well with high gain in that Janick Gers kind of vibe. It fits into typical Maiden style rock guitar solos nicely. It's a great way to add a bit of bluesy snap to any fast licks. Janick also does a lot of these double stop kind of bends. What I'm doing here is I'm playing the 14 on the G and the 15 on the B, but I'm bending the note on the 14 of the G up a full step. So what we end up with is this harmony. of these two notes, the 16 on the G and the 15 on the B, but via this bend. This kind of double stop appears a lot in Janick's guitar playing as well. And once again, like the other double stops, you can put this in at the start of a lick. And it's a great way just to get a bit more of a raw sound out of your guitar playing. As you've learned in this lesson, Janick is more about the raw approach. Adrian is the meticulous one. Dave is the smooth one. Janick is the completely off the wall, erratic, raw, kind of all over the place guitar player from Iron Maiden. And that's really the fun of what he brings to the band. Thank you all so much for watching this video on the guitar style and habits of Iron Maiden's Janick Gers. Don't forget to check out the other two Iron Maiden videos where we talk about the style of Adrian Smith and Dave Murray. There's some links for those down below in the description and also in the top corner of this video. Don't forget to head over to the Licklibrary YouTube channel and hit that subscribe button if you want to see more free guitar lessons just like this one. I hope you've all enjoyed this video. Please let me know down below in the comments how you got on with learning some of Janick's tips and tricks. And also, if there are any other artists or guitar players you'd like to see these videos about, please throw their names down below as well. Don't forget to check out licklibrary.com. If you want to take your playing to that next level, you can access the library of lessons over there. There's a huge array of content from song and album breakdowns through to guitar player styles, through to one-to-one sessions with some of the Licklibrary team. There's something there for everyone that will take your playing to that next level, so go check that out as well. All the links you need are down below in the description, as well as the timestamps for every section of this video. Thank you all so much for watching, as always, and I'll see you all very, very soon.